it isn't uncommon to follow in an older sibling's footsteps. Especially when those steps, in this case dance steps, lead you center stage of arguably the loudest arena with the most loyal fans in basketball. Zach Estudillo was co-captain of the Junior Jam Squad, a group of kids aged 7 to 13 who perform high-energy hip-hop routines at Golden State Warriors games and community events.
The atmosphere of the Oracle is something else. It's exuberance and energy, it's liveliness, you know, the vibrancy.
Older brother KJ knows the feeling because he too was on the Junior Jam Squad 14 years ago.
To be my final year at the 2007 We Believe, I mean, it was a big deal to go playoffs, right? And now to dance the championship games and the finals, like, I'm jealous.
However, believing in the power of dance and in the talent of their favorite basketball team are not the only things these brothers have in common. These brothers literally have shared their lives.
Basically, God touched their lives. Some people go through life not knowing their purpose. Zach realized his purpose at the age of 2.
At 12 years old, KJ was hit by a pitch during a baseball game. After being taken to the doctor for severe bruising, the family was thrown their own curveball that no one saw coming.
I remember that day because KJ was in front of me and the doctor was behind, and she had mouthed something like, it might be leukemia. I'm like, what?
I left the room and I was like, I have cancer? I'm 12 years old. Like, how do I have cancer all of a sudden?
After a series of tests, leukemia was ruled out, but KJ was not in the clear just yet.
I specifically remember it was me, my mom, and Dr. Wong, and he just basically told me, like, you have aplastic anemia. These are the steps we can take.
KJ needed a bone marrow transfusion to save his young life.
He would have to go to the National Bone Marrow Registry called Be The Match, and Filipinos are just not registered. It was like a point, less than a percent.
With numbers not in their favor, doctors turned to immediate family members in hopes to find a match for KJ. What happened next, the Estudillo family believes, is divine intervention.
By the grace of God, Zach was a perfect 8-for-8 match.
Though Zach was a perfect match for his brother, the family was worried his growing 2-year-old body would not be able to handle the burden of producing enough bone marrow for KJ.
There was a big height and weight discrepancy. So while KJ was getting 4 days of chemo to wipe out the system, Zach was getting HGC shots to boost up his bone marrow.
While KJ knew the transfusion was necessary to save his life, he too was concerned for his baby brother's well-being.
I was scared, you know, he's 2 years old. I knew that, you know, granted that I'm going through it, that I'm gonna battle it out.
The transplant and the leap of faith took place on May 17th, 2005. The brothers were reunited days after their procedures. 12 years since the successful bone marrow transplant, KJ and Zach are your typical teenage boys with a very special story. Because of that, the brothers are advocates for the Asian American donor program, sharing their experience so more Filipinos can join the registry.
I tell people how important it is to at least go try it. Just do a cheek swab, see if you're a match. You never know whose life you can save.
What I did at the age of 2, you know, it was great significance to saving my older brother's life. I mean, the whole situational circumstance, it wasn't some fortuitous fluke that I just came down from God. It was, you know, my family had to bring faith to him.
You're just so thankful. God is so good. And so to see that, you know, Zach holding, you know, that bone marrow, you're just so thankful.
Whether Zach continues to follow in the footsteps of KJ or carves his own path, the brothers will forever share a special story of unconditional love, faith, and purpose.